So let's say you just upgraded your iPhone. Your old iPhone had a home button and your new one does not. The iPhone X, XR, XS, and iPhone 11 all have an edge-to-edge display with no home button. The latest iPhones also don't have 3D touch. And in iOS 13, Apple has really expanded the gestures and commands available. So whether you're new to the iPhone or an old pro, you may want to bookmark this video because I'm going to run rapid fire through all the important commands and gestures to control a modern iPhone that has no home button. Let's start simple. To go back to the home screen, swipe up from the bottom edge of your phone. To jump back and forth between recent apps, swipe left and right along the bottom edge of the display. To show the app switcher interface, swipe up and pause with your finger on the screen. It only takes a split second for the app cards to show up. With the app switcher open, just drag up on the app card to close that app. It doesn't need to be the topmost app, and you can even swipe up on multiple apps at once. To view your notifications, swipe down from the top left edge. To access Control Center, swipe down from the top right edge. This is also where you'll see your battery percentage. To get to your widgets, swipe right on the first home screen. There's an edit button at the bottom to choose which widgets you want to see and their order. Tap and hold on any app icon and you'll soon see a pop-up menu of shortcuts for that app, followed by two options, rearrange apps and share app. Choose rearrange apps and all of your apps will wiggle with a little X in the corner. You can now drag apps around to move them where you want them, drag apps on top of each other to make folders, and tap the little X in the corner to delete the app. You can also get into this state by simply continuing to hold down on an app icon even after the menu appears. If your iPhone is too big for you to comfortably tap on things near the top of the screen, use reachability. You have to turn it on first by going into Settings, Accessibility, and Touch. To use it, swipe down on the bottom edge of the screen, making the whole display shift downward. Swipe up again, or just wait a few seconds, and it returns to normal. A lot of the features of 3D touch have been replicated by haptic touch, which is a fancy way of saying long press with vibration. You can long press on links, phone numbers, addresses, dates and times, app icons. You should just experiment. A lot of control center icons have additional features when you long press on them too. Starting with iOS 13, you can now drag the scroll bar in almost any app that has one. Just tap and hold on it to grab it and then scroll up and down quickly. In most apps that scroll vertically, you can tap at the top of the screen to quickly zoom back to the beginning. In apps that let you select multiple items like files or photos, tap with two fingers and drag to select multiple items at once. Let's talk about editing text, which got a bunch of new gestures and controls in iOS 13. There are two ways to move the text cursor. Simply tap and drag it where you want it to go, or tap and hold on the spacebar. You'll see the labels turn blank, and then you can drag your finger around like a touchpad. To select a word, double tap it. To select a sentence, triple tap. You can even select an entire paragraph by, you guessed it, quadruple tapping. To undo your last change, swipe left with three fingers. To redo, swipe right with three fingers. Do a three-finger pinch gesture to copy your selection. Do that three-finger pinch twice in a row to cut that selection. Do the three-finger pinch in reverse to paste wherever the cursor is. If you find those three-finger gestures difficult, try using the edit bar. Just tap anywhere on the screen with three fingers. You'll see a bar at the top of the screen with undo, cut, copy, paste, and redo. Those are the basics for tapping and dragging. Let's talk about those buttons. To take a screenshot, press the side button and the volume up button at the same time. If you want to invoke Siri without saying, "Hey Siri," press and hold the side button. To use Apple Pay, double tap the side button. The fastest way to use Apple Pay is to do this while looking at your phone to quickly authenticate your default card with Face ID and then hold your iPhone to the payment terminal. If you want to disable Face ID, press and hold the side button and either volume button for a few seconds. You'll feel a little tap, tap, tap to let you know it worked. It's designed to be easy to do even while in your pocket without looking. Face ID won't work until you use your passcode to unlock your iPhone. This way, someone who steals your phone or even law enforcement can't just hold your phone up to your face to make you unlock it. This gesture is also how you fully power off your iPhone. Just press and hold until you see the slide to power off option and use that. If you keep holding down the side button along with a volume button, your phone will make a loud tone and then call emergency services. Finally, if your iPhone just becomes totally unresponsive, here's how you force it to reset. Quickly press and release the volume up button, then the volume down button, then press and hold the side button. Keep holding that side button until the Apple logo appears, which should take about 15 to 20 seconds. Then you can let go. Now, that list is hardly every possible thing you can do with your iPhone, but it should cover the basics and then some. If you're new to the iPhone, I hope it helped. If you're not new to the iPhone, maybe sharing this video with someone who is will keep them from asking you how to do everything.